Hey there. Today is the first day of July. It is really hot and humid out. I'm going to talk about reeds. Why? Because all of my reeds suck right now. Because it's so hot and humid and they're just not used to it. It's the first really nasty day here in Brooklyn. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take you through my process of, opening up a box or two of reeds, trying them out, and figuring out what I'm going to do with them as I break them in. First thing I want to mention to you is when you get a good reed out of a box, if you're so lucky, you don't get to just play it and play it and play it. You're like, oh my God, I finally have a reed that works. No, no, no. What happens to that reed is that it will die a very quick death. And you don't want that, especially if it's a good reed. So you have to have some patience and discipline to not play on them over and over and over again because it happens to be the only reed that is any good. You're going to have to play on the old crappy reeds for a while, I'm afraid. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to open the box up and I'm going to thank Van Doren for having such incredibly eco-friendly packaging. We'll take it from there. Be right back. Okay, so here I have all of the packaging. And I have the reeds. What I do is actually go ahead and I write on each reed case here a number. It's a unique number. It's how I identify the reeds. I basically, every year I start at zero and work my way up to see how many reeds I go through in a year. Right now, this is reed number 70. What I will also do, typically, because the reeds do come out of them, I write on the butt of the reed the same number, so that I know which reed goes into its house. Do I use really expensive, reed holders? I have a couple of them, I'll occasionally use them. But to be honest with you, I don't. I actually keep them inside the little plastic cases. I put them inside a Ziploc bag, and let me show you what I put in with it. This is how I keep my reeds. It's a Ziploc bag, and inside the Ziploc bag, besides my reeds, is this, which is a humidistat. What it does is it tells the temperature and the humidity inside this bag, and the humidity inside this bag is controlled by this little floppy thing. It's a little pouch that's called a humidistat. Rico sells these branded. I buy mine from cigar shops online because they're cheaper, but you can buy them from Rico. They come in various humidities. This one is 69. You can get them in the 70s or the 80s, or some of them even go down into the low 50s. It really depends on what your thing is. I chose this one. It works here by absorbing humidity that is in excess of 69%, and it releases humidity when inside here, like in the wintertime, is in when it needs more humidity. It keeps it around 69%. It's not perfect. In the summertime, it's absorbing a lot of humidity. Okay, so back to the reeds. What I've done is I let them soak while I sat here and talked to you, and I'm going to take the first reed. Again, I marked all of them on the back side of the reed right back there. It says 70, so I know where it goes. I just soak it for about a minute. I don't want to soak them until they're really, really soggy. In fact, I think I'm going to take them out because it's so humid. I don't want them to get too waterlogged. They're waterlogged when you can start to see, a little bit of translucency in the tip of the reed. Okay, so here I go. I've got my reed on and I'm going to give it a shot. Here we go. So that's a little soft for me. I'm just putting a little bit of pressure with my jaw, my lip, my embouchure to see where it starts to close the reed off. It's okay. It's a little soft because it's super humid out. So I'm going to give that one, the benefit of the doubt. I'm not going to play it much more than that. I'm going to play through the rest of them. This one is 71. Okay, that one has really crummy articulation. Reed number two. It's again feels a little bit waterlogged. Now, humid days, maybe this isn't the best time to do reed testing. Maybe I should have found something a little bit more, maybe not so hot, not so humid, but whatever. It's not ideal still because, the articulation's a little fuddy, but I like him. I'm going to put him aside. All right, 73. You know, and wipe the reeds off so they're not full of water when you stick them on your mouthpiece. Okay, so I like that one. It sounds reedy. It's, you know, it's got a decent articulation to it. All right, I'm going to set him aside as well. And finally, the last of the bunch of five. Here we go. Him on right? Yes, I did. Okay, so I've tried all of my reeds, and the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take a spiral bound notebook and I'm going to make a log of each of those five reeds. I'm going to put a rough temperature and a rough humidity out. This is a hot and humid day. And I'm going to say reed 70 played, you know, a little bit soft, reed 71 was too hard, 72 was really good, 73 was excellent, 74 was kind of meh. And then I'm gonna put them away. I'm not gonna sand them, I'm not gonna play them anymore. Then, tomorrow or the next day, when it is hopefully not as hot and humid, I'm going to take them back out and I'm gonna try them all over again. And I'm gonna make a note of what the temperature and the humidity is, and I will not be surprised at all if the reeds that I thought were excellent just now, I'm not gonna like in when the weather has changed. It's just the way it is. But the great thing about that is, when you then know that, say, reed number 70 works really great when it's hot and humid, and reed number 74 works excellent when it's not hot and humid, then I don't sit and start filing reeds down for individual days, because eventually they're not going to work on any days. So I keep my reeds sort of separated to what the temperature and humidity is, especially if the temperature and humidity change a lot from day to day. Okay? Again, like, I don't sand them at all. After a few days, I'm going to start playing them a little bit more, 5-10 minutes. And then after about a week or so, what I do is I take a very fine piece of sandpaper, 1200, 1600 grit, stuff that doesn't feel like sandpaper at all. And I'm just going to sand the tops of each of the reeds so that they aren't so rough. That's just a personal preference. I don't like rough feeling reeds. I don't know, maybe my tongue is delicate. Okay, so I hope this was really helpful. Gosh, I hope it is not as hot where you are as it is where I am. And I will see you next time.